Hello students, welcome back. So once again we find out the type of given binary mixture. Binary organic mixture meaning there are two organic compounds which are clubbed together in this mixture. Okay, so what do I need to do is I need to find out what are the compounds present in this mixture. Like you know, the possibilities are acid, phenol, base and neutral. And for me to find out their types, I will be using only these four things. What are they? Water. The other reagents are sodium bicarbonate, sodium hydroxide and HCl. What is the purpose of me using water? To find out the solubility. Okay, so what I do is I take some amount of the mixture. To this I add water. Now I know the quantity of the compound which I have taken, approximately. Now what I see is there is slight decrease in the quantity, meaning one of the compound could be water soluble, though it may not be and the best test to find out the solubility, so we can get back to it a little later. Next, I take small amount of the compound. To this I add sodium bicarbonate. Well, tell me one thing, can you see effervescence here? Of course I see effervescence. What does that mean? It means carboxylic acid is present for sure, right? What does this confirm? This confirms that out of these two compounds, one of the compound is water soluble. So is a carboxylic acid. Whether it is water soluble or water insoluble, I need to find out. So just tell me one thing. This is filtrate and this is residue. Inside the filtrate, do you have the salt of the carboxylic acid which reacted with sodium bicarbonate? Yes. So what I do is I filter it. So when I filter it, this is residue. What is the residue? Can you tell me? Is it acid? No. Then what is it? It could either be phenol, base or neutral. This is my filtrate. To this, if I add HCl, I was expecting that the acid should have regenerated. But there is no regeneration of the acid, which means what? The given carboxylic acid is water soluble, right? So it is now confirmed that the acid which we get in this binary mixture was water soluble acid. Now both the components cannot be water soluble. Then it becomes difficult for us to separate them. By the way, this separation of organic compounds by using these reagents is known as chemical separation. So now just tell me one thing. This is the residue which is left behind. Now what is this residue? Is it a binary mixture or is it a single component? Of course it is single component. Why? Because there was one carboxylic acid which has been removed completely. This compound could either be a phenol or it could be a base or it could be neutral. So let me check it for the presence of any phenol. For phenols, I add sodium hydroxide. Does it dissolve in sodium hydroxide? No, it means it is not a phenol. Next, if it is a base, it would react with HCl. Does it react with HCl? No, it is left behind, see, which means it is not a base. What does that mean? It means that one of the component is neutral. Why? Because it shows no reaction with sodium bicarbonate, sodium hydroxide or HCl. Is it soluble or insoluble? Of course it is water insoluble because all of these reagents were made in water. Now there is one question. How do you separate the entire bulk mixture? What you can do is, now you know one thing, that one of the component is water soluble. So what I do is, to this I add water. So when I add water, which component will dissolve in water? It is like what, you know, it is like if you have a mixture of sand and sodium chloride, how do you separate them? You add water, sodium chloride dissolves in water, you filter it, the filtrate has water and sodium chloride, you heat it, evaporate the water, you'll get the sodium chloride back. So this is what exactly I'm going to do here. What I'm going to do is, I had a water soluble component. The water soluble component, how is it separated from water insoluble component? By adding water. Okay. Now what I do is, to this, I carry out the separation. The separation is carried out in such a way that the component which is left behind here, is it water soluble or water insoluble? It is water insoluble. Why? Because it does not dissolve in water. Now can you tell me, what do we get here? This is water plus the water soluble component. Now how do I remove the water? Of course by heating it. So now what I will do is, I will start heating. See, this is water insoluble component. This is the water insoluble component. We just found out it is water insoluble neutral. And this is the water soluble component. Now what I'll do is, I will start heating it. I will start heating it. And when I start heating it, water will evaporate. And after some time, I will get the solid back. So what I'll do is, I'll start heating it, and after heating it, I'll show you how the solid remains. Yes, so what I did was, I heated it for around 15 minutes, and after heating it, I get my water soluble acid back. Okay, the water has been evaporated, and I get my water soluble acid back. Beautiful crystals of the water soluble acid. This way, we separated a water soluble component from a water insoluble component.